satellite retirement, solar eclipse, and SDO is Lego on your SpacePod for July 14th, 2010.
Apollo Control Houston, we've just had loss of signal from Honeysuckle.
If you ever seen an older Apollo landing, or even the movie Apollo 13, you may remember a point when the spacecraft was re-entering the atmosphere and then mission control would lose all communication. This was because the radio signals could not penetrate the massive plasma and ionization blast occurring underneath the vehicle. This blackout phenomenon happened until 1988 when the first part of the TDRS, or Tracking and Data Relay Satellite System, came online. Since then, the re-entry signals have been sent back up to space, away from the plasma and ionization layer, to the TDRS satellites, and from there, relayed back down to Earth. This satellite network serves many other uses as well, and is a key element in constant and flawless communication for human spaceflight. Now, part of the TDRS legacy has retired. TDRS-1, which was the first of these space-to-ground communication satellites in the network, has been removed from service as of late last month. Living well past its expected 7-year lifespan, this little 27-year-old bird was instrumental in many key communication milestones. This was one of the satellites that helped send the first tweet from space, as well as the first global broadcast event at the South Pole for New Year's Eve at the turn of the millennia. TDRS-1, how we'll miss you. Now, changing gears slightly, did you have a chance to see the total solar eclipse that happened on July 11th? Yeah. Me neither. Problem was that this eclipse was a narrow column that was visible from the South Pacific Ocean. Now here's a map that shows the path of totality. That's a whole lot of water on that map. I should have booked an eclipse cruise. Actually, that would have been awesome. Now if you missed this one, fret not. You'll have another chance to view a total solar eclipse on November 13th. Unfortunately, that's in the year 2012. Well, now let's close up the space pod with a little geekery. Okay, well, more geekery than normal, at least. Lego has released their Shuttle Adventure Pack. For $100, you get this set of awesome. The external fuel tank and solid rocket boosters all separate, and the landing gear on this bad boy even works. Look at that. Bam! It's about $100, and speaking of Legos, we actually have the SDO kit as well. We haven't been able to find this one online, but we really wanted to put it in the space pod just so we could say SDO is Lego. Make sure to tweet that out to NASA SDO so they know you watch the show. Okay, well, I can't end the pod on a bad pun, so here's a shot from the real SDO. This is our own sun as shown in the extreme ultraviolet light from our Solar Dynamics Observatory. Enjoy.